have come up to me. An intersex child came up to me, actually a man, and he was talking about how he was mutilated as an infant and he's trying to restore what the doctors messed up because they chose his sex for him, or her, it was a girl. So they removed the clitoris. And yeah, and I was trying to explain to him ours isn't just for boys, it's for male, female, intersex children. We're trying to spread awareness of why this is like terrible.
Well, I was born intersex, but because of standard medical practice based around John Money's philosophy, which is outlined in the book, by the way, I was forced through genital surgery manipulation and forced to live my life as though I was a girl. You know, everything I went through just was so harsh based on this philosophy of secrecy and forced genital mutilation. I was fairly unaware of what my surgeries were all about. Now, I understood that I was going through surgery, but all I was ever told is, oh, you're a normal girl, but the doctors are going to make you all better. You know, you just have a small problem and the doctors will all fix it for you. Well, the problem, as I understood it, is because I was going to these university hospitals, there were several wet residents standing around watching as a doctor poked and prodded at my genitals, stuck things inside this vagina that they had created out of a vaginoplasty, because I wasn't born with one. So, like, it was really sensitive, and, like, as a child, I felt like I was being molested, almost raped, while my parents and these other doctors watched on. Well, I knew I was definitely more masculine, and my parents were in denial, because when the doctors said my mom could have a little girl and that I was a little girl, she just went with it, because, you know, what I found out recently was the doctors threatened to call CPS on my mom and have me taken away from her and have this foster home do these surgeries to me anyway. So she just went ahead and, you know, she was young and didn't really understand what was going on. I know she had to have been scared and felt guilty, but she was just doing what the doctors told her to do. And, you know, I don't believe that she honestly knew what to do at the time after I've had time to get to know her, figure out what's going on. And now people like me, they'll blame their doctors, blame their parents, but it's the whole philosophy behind it. And it is also outlined, you know, in As Nature Made Him, The Boy Who Was Raised as a Girl. You know, it goes through both sides of it, where Milton Diamond says no to John Money, that he's wrong, and he never did any medical follow-up into David Reimer's future, you know, when he was an adult later on. You know, he just said, no, I'm right, you know, just never any medical follow-up. So as a doctor, how can you really know for sure if there's no adult follow-up on childhood surgery? You know, I mean, how? I mean, that's not scientifically feasible, you know? I found out about it when I was about 18 years old. I was in a girls' counseling group. And my counselor, you know, is asking me, well, you know, why do you feel so different? Because I told her about how I really felt, because at the time I really thought I was just a lesbian, you know, because I was raised to believe. But I knew that there was something going on. I felt that all throughout my childhood, but I could never really put my finger on what was really up that I was not being told. And through this counseling session, I explained my adrenal insufficiency to my counselor, and then by the next week that I had seen her, she had investigated on it and found this webpage of intersex people who had gone through exactly what I had gone through. And I read it and I'm like, wow, that's me, you know, that's what I've gone through. So, you know, then I went through more investigation, and I became like so angry with my mom, so angry with doctors, so angry with everybody, that, you know, I was willing to fist fight over it. So I decided the best thing for me was to go to college. You know, I took philosophy, history at the time Prop 8 was going on, and I would argue in class with my teacher, who used to be a lawyer, so he loved it. And you know, I would argue, I'm like, how can you establish this, you know? I'm like, you know, what about this? You know, and I mean, I'm sure it caused a little stir in the small town school, but you know, I had to. The fire was in me at that point, and I had to outlet my anger in a constructive way, and that was the only constructive outlet that I had. You know, otherwise it's come home and fight about it with my mom, which would have gone nowhere. I decided that with that information, once I wrapped my head around it finally, that I was gonna wait a little bit, see how things went, see how I really felt about myself. I just took some time for me, which I had never really done ever before. And I was talking to a girlfriend of mine, and she's like, well, you know, if you feel that way, why don't we go have your hair cut? So I cut my hair and came home, and my mom had a riot act. She threw a fit. She's like, you're trying to be a boy. I'm like, well, you know, we've already argued about that, Mom, and you already know where this is going, so, you know. And then it just took some time to figure out, you know, some things, you know, get information that I needed to figure out where to go from there. Because at that point, once I cut my hair, I decided that I was planning on going all the way through with it. You know, that there was no stopping me. I just needed to figure out where to go and how to get there. You know, so I made another friend that someone had introduced to me in college, and he told me about this local doctor who pointed out that what used to be called the Benjamin Standards of Care, which is now called WPATH. I'm not sure what the acronym stands for, though. Yes, I'm looking to seek a total phalloplasty, as it's known as. I am seeking it through the Sava Perovic Foundation, which is headquartered in Belgrade, Serbia. Believe it or not, it is a beautiful country over there. Don't believe anything the media tells you about that country. It's amazing. It's a beautiful language. I love their food. And but anyway, the Sava Perovic Foundation specializes in genital surgeries for female to male and male to female as well. It also specializes in such things as penis enlargement and other such things. They pioneer in that field, so there's always something new and updated, safer and better for, you know, total phalloplasty. I am trying to acquire the funding that I need for at least the first stage of my phalloplasty within the next year and a half. That alone amounts to about $20,000 currently, because this doctor charges in euros, so the price is always slightly fluctuating according to the euro market. And then the other surgeries plus flight time, I mean flight costs, you know, finding a place to stay, things like that. I'm looking at, you know, a grand total of about $45,000 to $50,000. I'm hoping to have the surgery completed within the next 3 years. I have a GoFundMe page. You know, it'll be available right here in the description on the bottom of this video. If you ever see me in person or add me on Facebook, anything like that, you know, you can talk to me in person. You know, I don't mind, you know, sharing information with other people, you know, because information like that should be free. Because of things like Prop 8 and other such issues coming up, like Australia and Germany have recognized intersex as a third gender, which, you know, many intersex activists out there will say is a bad idea because it sets up a wall, a divide. So when you start putting a label on somebody, on something, especially intersex or trans issues, you're putting up a divide within your own community, whether you're gay, straight, intersex, trans, whatever you label yourself, if you label yourself at all. So the thing is if the medical definition of male or female cannot be established on the basis of there being intersex conditions, then how can you define male and female on a legal basis? From there, you know, if there is no legal basis for it, then how can you really say who can get married and who can't? And if you focus on that philosophy rather than, you know, you're gay, you're straight, you're male, you're female, you're black, you're white, you know, you put up a wall within anybody's community, and we should all be coming together as one, as the human race, you know, make some positive change for ourselves and each other for change.